Y'all ready? I would like to introduce to you our prompt mistress, Frida Kahlo!
And it was the 90s, so
yeah.
We've upgraded this version just for
damn.
Just a tad.
So, a quick recap. Finale of the original series, Queen Latina's mentor, the Demi-Goddess Shayzee, went over to the dark side. In fact, the whole reason Shayzee sought out a champion was to counter this very eventuality. As it turned out, Liza, Queen Latina, was forced to kill her mentor and her best friend by shooting her with all the love in her being. And thus the universe was saved! And Liza was so very heartbroken. So much so that she disbanded the Power Posse and retired from superheroing.
Oh, man. No.
Fast forward to 2016. Where we find Analisa Lalaloca.
Let's see what happens if we try to send an email to see if we can interview her as a writer.
Maybe they'll send an email or pass a message along.
It's worth a try.
Yes, queen. Hey, hey, yes, queen. Yes.
Queen two. The campaign HQ of presidential candidate Donald Trump. With his bevy of minions.
Set up a press conference where I can blame my opponent, Tiffany Plimpton, for an internet attack, and the hurricane that just hit Haiti, and the fact that they can't cure the common cold.
Yes, sir, Mr. Trumpet!
And set out a Tweety storm against Michelle Bama, President Bama, Cher. blame them for global warming. Then deny it. Then say it was all a conspiracy China made up.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Trump it.
And bring me 15 beauty contestants into my office so I can smooch them and grab them without consent. Then tell them they're all so fat and ugly they wouldn't even rate a 4.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Trump it.
And tell my wife, Melanania. She's a rock.
Yes,
yes. Tell all the Mexicans and the blacks and the gays that I hate them. Let's get this campaign machine rolling. You're the puppets, and I'm the boogeyman.
I want to do it all. I want to go all in. I want to go all in.
working!
Yes, sir, Mr. Trumpet! I mean, Lord Chaos!
Yes, Silent Andreas! Now that we are alone, we can finally be ourselves! Who would have thought that this ridiculous orange-faced fool's form would have brought me so far? But simply by fanning the fires of hatred and bigotry, I am well on my way to becoming President of the United States!
Yes! Ignore your entrees! Your demon of discord is forever at your side, great son of Loki!
Yes! Finally, with the fall of America, my father, the great trickster god Loki, will finally see me as his son! And not some half-human bastard! Daddy will finally love me!
Yes! Yes! Well, perhaps.
Perhaps?
If I may delicately remind you, Lord Chaos, you are not yet President of the United States. And if you should fail to rally the hatred of the country and turn the dark hearts of America into votes, you would have failed again, and your daddy would despise you even more.
Shut up! Shut up! Do not speak of failure! I will succeed! I will become president!
Perhaps you'll succeed this time, as there's no Queen Latina to foil your plans.
Don't dare mention that nasty woman's name! Yes!
Oh my God.
Analisa and Rocky Skypey with Liza Colonia.
She doesn't exist anymore.
Yes, about that. You had an amazing, if brief, career. I mean, you fought and defeated Jim Dandy, the pedophile cannibal, the queen pin of crime de la Gloria, the reincarnation of the Greek Furies, and the purported son of Loki, Lord Chaos.
A regular rogue of gallery of rogues, but I had plenty of help from my friends in the Power Posse. Couldn't have done it without them.
And Shayzee?
How do you know about Shayzee?
I'm sorry, does this make you feel uncomfortable?
How do you know about Shayzee?
Well, there's this rare video footage of your confrontation with Jim Dandy, and Shayzee is seen in it for a few seconds. The audio is intact, which is why I know about Shayzee. So what happened?
Shayzee was my mentor and my friend. She chose me to be her champion for this world, but also to be a safeguard in case Shayzee should become evil.
Did that happen?
It did.
There's no documentation of that fight!
No, because it happened on a different plane of reality than the one we live in.
Different plane of reality? Whoa. This is surreal.
That's one way to describe it.
You seem so sad right now.
During the battle with Shayzee, I was forced to. I had to kill her. I killed my mentor and my friend to save the universe. I fired the love gun at her full blast repeatedly. She begged me to kill her. The darkness was taking over. The only thing that could stop her was the power of love. It stopped her, it ended her. I couldn't go on being Queen Latina after that. It destroyed my heart, I felt lost. I disbanded the Power Posse, quit writing, left to try and start all over again. Now I feel hollow, empty. I'm like a ghost.
Liza, if it makes you feel any better, we want to thank you. Thank you for everything you've done for us. Thank you for telling us your secret. And I promise I won't tell anybody why you stopped being Queen Latina.
Your story's safe with us.
Thank you.
And if there's anything I can do to help, just ask.
Actually, there is.
Yes?
When Shayzee chose me for her champion, she explained that there must always be a champion for good. But now that Shayzee is gone, the task falls on me to find the next champion. Analisa. Will you rise to the challenge? Will you be the next Queen Latina?
Me, but how I...
I still retain a small portion of my powers, one of them being the ability to see goodness and love in a person's heart. Mm. Your heart radiates goodness and love.
Yeah.
It's like...
But how do I don't even know where I'd begin. I'm not a hero, I'm just a student.
And I was a substitute teacher. But Analisa, heroes are not born, they are made. What makes someone heroic is if they find the strength to step up to a challenge when needed, to answer the call when sent. Will you accept?
Yes, I accept.
I think.
Yes.
Excellent.
So, that's it? I don't feel any different.
You will. Go look on your dresser. You will find the love gun.
What?
It is now linked to you. It will harvest the power of your heart.
But how is it suddenly here?
It's part of the mystery. When the time comes, there will be others who will come to your aid. Right, Rocky?
Excuse me?
Goodbye for now, my champions. And let freedom ring.
Scene 4. 1 minute late.
How the heck did it get here?
Liza said it's part of its mystery. I wonder what its other mysteries are.
Yeah, like, how does it work? Is it loaded? This is crazy!
I don't know. Try firing it.
What? No, I might break something.
You're right. Let's wait and call Liza back to get instructions. In the meantime, maybe we should think about a costume.
I don't have a costume.
Well, let's think. I've got plenty of sports gear that kind of looks superhero-ish. You've got a cape and gloves. No, they look like the ones Liza used to wear. Oh, Gino, I want to be a superhero.
Well, who would you be?
Well, I'm good at kickboxing, and Liza could call me Rock Out. Maybe that's who I should be. I'm Rock Out. What?
Yes, we're a team. We love it.
I don't know. I didn't invite anybody over. Who is it?
Yes. It's me, Neil from down the hall.
What's up, Neil?
I was doing some new engineering designs and I ran out of coffee. What chance do you have any? I know you stay up late doing research, too.
Just a minute, Neil. What do I do? Send him away?
Act normal.
Right. Come on in! Hey!
I didn't realize you had company. I'm so sorry, I'll come back later. Yes, yes, I know who you are. We had advanced physics last semester. You're beautiful. I mean, you're brilliant. You're brilliant. In the brain.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I'm sure I'm not.
Please, yes. Can we ask you to be on our team?
What? We've been a team for like 5 minutes and you're ready to expand?
Well, he can invent things for us, like gadgets, gizmos, and such.
No, it's a secret.
Well, let's test him, see if he's trustworthy. Come on.
Here's the coffee, Neil.
Thanks.
Hey, Neil, can I ask you a hypothetical question?
You can ask me anything, Rocky.
And this is hypothetical, right?
The hypothetical, got it.
If someone were to reveal to you a strange and exciting secret, would you be able to keep it no matter what?
If this hypothetical person were, say, a brilliant chemistry student with awesome hair and the sweetest face, yes, 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 I'd keep that secret no matter what.
Okay, I'm gonna hurl.
Neil, would you swear to keep that secret? I'm hypothetically speaking.
Yes, you can count on me, Rocky.
He's just saying that because he's all goo-goo for you. He doesn't mean it.
Oh, of course he does. And I think we should ask him to be our team inventor.
What? We don't know him.
Well, I have a good feeling about him and I trust him.
Well, I don't.
Neil, how do you feel about heroic deeds?
Is this another hypothetical question?
No, this one's legit.
Well, there are acts of heroism all around us, firefighters. Doctors, teachers come to mind.
Yes, that's so sweet.
So what about you, Neil? Have you done anything heroic?
Well, I suppose not.
See, no hero. Thanks, Neil. Good night.
It appears to be an empathic converter in the form of a firearm. Where'd you get it?
Could you get it to work?
Well, I'd have to run some tests, but it seems to be to some specific empathic spectrum.
Meaning?
Meaning is calibrated to one person, and we have to find that person, which might be challenging. Again, I ask, where did you get it?
It's Queen Latina's love gun.
Oh my God, I've heard of her. Did she give this to you? When? No one's heard from her in years.
She sent it to me.
That's trusting of her.
Can I trust you to keep quiet about this?
Yes. I wouldn't want the wrong person to know you had this. You could be in some real danger.
See? You're right. I could be in some real danger. And now you could be in some real danger too, now that you know about it.
Wait a minute. The love gun, the cape and the gloves. Are you telling me that you're the new Queen Latina?
Yes! She is! And I'm her sidekick, Rock Out!
Amazing! I'm not really meant to be a superhero.
Of course not. What I mean is, will you be our gizmo engineer and surveillance specialist?
Well, since you've asked Rocky, I'd be honored.
So I guess we're a power posse now.
Yes! Yes!
Wait a minute. Do I get a code name?
Sure. What do you want to be called? How about Weaponsmith?
Too violent.
Festus.
Too Greek.
And what about Machine Smith?
That has possibility. I got it. Machine Smith 5000.
I like it. It's settled then! Queen Latina and the Power Posse flies again!
None of us can actually fly, can we?
Boy, you know what I mean.
Yes! Yes!
At that very same moment, scene 5, HQ
nephew of campaign presidential candidate Donald Trump. AKA Lord Chaos.
Mr. Trumpet! They're protesters outside of the tower, sir. About 100 Mexican protesters with signs that say Trumpet makes America racist again.
Really? Why don't you go out there with your crew and bust them up a little bit? Tear their signs and whack them over the head with them.
Yes, sir, Mr. Trumpet!
It has begun! Let the chaos reign!
So now that we have a team, code names, and costumes, what's next?
Beats me. I'm as new to this as you are.
And I'm even newer.
Who is it?
It's me.
Sean!
Hey! It's my cousin Sean. What's up, Sean?
Man, I was just going to the movies and I saw a huge riot happening in front of Trumpet Towers. Some of Trumpet's security team are beating up on Mexican protesters. It's crazy. It's all over the news and Tweety. And for some reason, the police aren't intervening. They're just setting up barricades to curtail the situation. So I came up here since your place is closer than mine.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I sure am.
I anticipated that, and there's an Uber waiting for you downstairs.
What?
Yes!
Wait, what's happening?
Stay here. No time to explain. Let's go. We can change in the car.
What just happened?
Want some coffee?
Yes.
What? Yes.
In front of Trumpet Tower.
Hey!
We find a scene of chaos.
We are people, we are human, we are people, we are human, we are people, we are human.
Stephanie Rubeca Albert. From Trumpet Tower, where a scene of shocking chaos and violence has erupted between Mexican protesters and Trumpet security staff. They're protesters, and that's why I have key cards. The protesters were having a non-violent protest. They were having a non-violent protest today in response to the speech made by GOP presidential candidate Donald Trumpet, in which he called Mexicans rapists, structures, and criminals. The protesters arrived about an hour ago. They arrived about an hour ago with signs, carrying signs, and chanting, "We are people! We are human!" When then, about a dozen of Trumpet security staff, about a dozen of Trumpet security forces made a grandstand at the door. 10 minutes ago, it all grew, escalated to a fever pitch until it became a full-scale riot. The police seem not to be able to contain the situation.
OMG! How do we stop this? I don't know!
Black Lives Matter. Oh,